Merry birthday!
But Manny, it's Christmas!
No, it's Jesus' birthday!
Manny, it's Christmas!
Miss Chastity, it's Jesus' birthday! We're gonna need a new cake. Boys and girls, we are so excited that you're here with us for our brand new series, Jesus' Birthday Party, where we are talking all about how Christmas is the celebration of Jesus' birth. And we are so excited. We've got lots of fun stuff planned. Maybe even some cake, but not that cake. And boys and girls, if you're new, we are so excited that you're here. We want to hear from you, so text in your name and the word new to the number on the screen, because we send fun letters, surprises, and all kinds of things every week to all of our friends. And you want to be on that list, so text in your name and the word new to the number on the screen. Miss Chastity.
Look, it's pink.
I know, we need to get you cleaned up and stop giving you cake. Boys and girls, we hope you join us for our brand new series, Jesus' Birthday Party. Bye! Bye.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Merry Christmas, boys and girls. My name is Manny, and I am so excited to be here with you today. Whether you're joining us online or in person, we want you to know we love when you come and learn about Jesus with us. Now, we are in our brand new Christmas series called Jesus' Birthday Party, and it's gonna be—
Whoa. Wait just a minute. Did I just hear birthday party? This is a Christmas party.
Piper the party planner, did you want to introduce yourself to the boys and girls?
Manny, I don't have time for this. But all right. Okay, I am Piper the party planner. I am the best party planner ever. If you have a party, I will plan it. And I will be handing out business cards later.
Well, Piper, you know, this is a Christmas party, but it's also Jesus' birthday too, right?
No. This is a Christmas party. Christmas is Christmas. Do you not see the trees, the ornaments, the nutcrackers? Like, come on. We don't have cake and candles for Christmas. Come on, Manny. All right, here is your to-do list. Get these tasks done by the end of the day. I do not have time for this. Oh my gosh, I am so off schedule. Bradley, let's go. Oh.
Well, boys and girls, like I was saying, we are in our brand new series called Jesus' Birthday Party, and it's gonna be amazing, but we're celebrating Jesus' birthday and Christmas, and our task list says, task one, everyone is invited to be a part of God's story. Can you all say that with me? Everyone is invited to be a part of God's story. Great job. Now, before we go any further, let's all get nice and quiet and pray, okay? So everybody can get nice and quiet for me. God, we thank you so much for all that you've done for us and that you sent your son Jesus to us. And that's what we're celebrating at Christmas, is the birth of Jesus. Jesus, I ask that you be with all these boys and girls as they go through their week. Help them with whatever they need. And we thank you for all that you've done for us. And in your name we pray, Jesus, amen. All right, boys and girls, we got a super fun Christmas song ready for you. So everybody get up, stand up, and we'll do our first song.
We're gonna dance. Lift our hands, celebrate, it's Christmas. Light up the world, Jesus is born. Whoa, whoa. Raise your voice, make some noise, it's Christmas. Let's celebrate and shout for joy. There's a reason why we sing and why we celebrate. It's Christmas time, yeah, it's Christmas time. The season that he's given us a gift so great. It's Christmas time, yeah, it's Christmas time. He's the light of the world, come down to us. From heaven, now everyone sing. They're gonna dance, lift our hands, celebrate, it's Christmas. Light up the world, Jesus is born. Celebrate, Christmas time. Yeah, it's Christmas time. It's the season that he's given us a gift so great. It's Christmas time. Yeah, it's Christmas time. He's the light of the world. Come down to us. From heaven, now everyone sing. We're gonna dance, lift our hands, celebrate. It's Christmas, light of the world, Jesus is born. Raise your voice, make some noise, it's Christmas. Let's celebrate and shout for joy. It's Christmas, everybody.
Great job, everyone. I just love Christmas songs, and I especially love Christmas songs about Jesus. Now, let's get to our Bible story. So today, we are going to be in the New Testament, so towards the back in the book of Matthew, and we're going to be in chapter 1, so big number 1, and verse 18, so little number 18, and we're going to read about two people named Mary and Joseph. So let's read. This is how the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, came about. His mother, Mary, was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Okay, so you probably recognize this story if you've heard the Christmas story before, but let's get to our video and see, because I think someone else comes into the story too. We'll be right back.
The story of Christmas, Mary and Joseph. This is Mary. You see, Mary was the mother of Jesus, but before that happened, she lived in the town of Nazareth. Mary had no children because she lived according to God's law and had never been married.
Oops!
But she was engaged to marry a man named Joseph.
Heyo!
Hi, Joseph!
One day, an angel came to Mary and said,
Hi.
That God had chosen Mary. The angel said, God is with you. But Mary was afraid and confused.
Huh?
She wondered what the angel was talking about. Then the angel said, Don't be afraid. God loves you and wants to use you in a great way.
Me?
You will give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be very great, and he will be the king forever. Mary asked, but how can this happen? For she was not married yet and knew that she couldn't have a child until she was married. But the angel told Mary that the Holy Spirit would make her pregnant.
Wow!
So that the baby born will be holy and will be called the Son of God.
Wow!
The angel reminded her that nothing is impossible with God.
Okay, let's do this!
So Mary decided to trust God and all that he had planned for her. Before their wedding, Joseph found out that Mary was pregnant.
Wait, what?
He thought she had done something wrong. But Joseph was a man of God and decided to break off the engagement quietly so no one around town would think badly of Mary. While Joseph was thinking about all this, an angel appeared to him in a dream.
Oh. Hi?
The angel said, Joseph, don't be afraid to take Mary as your wife.
Huh, why?
The angel explained that Mary's baby was from God.
Wait, what?
The angel told Joseph that the baby's name would be Jesus, and he would save his people from their sins.
Oh, wow.
And when Joseph woke up, he did as the angel told him.
Hi.
You ready?
Really? Yeah!
And took Mary as his wife, while she was still pregnant with the Son of God. And so Joseph and Mary trusted in God, and the two followed the plan that God had given them to help bring the Savior into the world.
You're back. I love this part of the Christmas story. And what I love about this story today is that it reminds us of our big idea. Everyone is invited to be a part of God's story because Mary and Joseph were invited to be a part of God's story too. Now, let's get to our Bible verse. I hear we have some special guests here. So let's get to our Bible verse and we'll be right back.
Hi, boys and girls. My name is Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Let's get into our Bible verse. We're in Luke 2:10, and it says, "The angel said to them, 'Don't be afraid, because I am bringing you some good news. It will be joy to all people. Today, your Savior was born in David's town. He is Christ the Lord.'" That was so much fun. Bye-bye.
Oh, I'm so excited that you're back. This is my favorite part of the video. It's the object lesson, and we've got a to-do list today. And on our to-do list, it says we need to take care of invitations. Now, what I love about invitations is they can remind us of our big idea. Everyone is invited to be a part of God's story and the Bible story today. So in our Bible story, Gabriel invited Mary and Joseph to be a part of God's story. Now, he didn't give them invitations, but he did the same thing that invitations do for us, right? He asked them to be a part of God's story. And just like our big idea says, everyone is invited to be a part of God's story. Everyone is you guys. It's all of us. So I'm curious, has anybody here ever gotten an invitation to go to a party? I see quite a few of you have, right? I just love parties. They are so fun. And the amazing thing about getting an invitation to a party is all you have to do is accept it, right? Usually you don't get an invitation to cook the meal or to do all of these things. You don't have a checklist of things you have to do. The invitation is just telling you, hey, come to the party. We want you there. We want you to be a part of it. And it's amazing because that's exactly what Jesus did when he invited us to be a part of God's family. He did all the work. When Jesus came to earth, which is what we're talking about at Christmas, right? That Jesus came to earth for us. And when he came to die on the cross for not everybody, for not his own sins, but for everybody else's sins. Because Jesus was perfect. And when he went to the cross, boys and girls, and rose again, he did everything for you so that you didn't have to die, so that you don't have to do all the work to be a part of God's family. Jesus did that for you. Now, what I want to do today is give you the chance, if you've never accepted his invitation to be a part of God's family. I know we talk about that around here a lot, but I want to give you the chance today to pray that prayer, to accept Jesus into your heart, to be a part of your life. So everybody, if everybody could get nice and quiet and pray with me. And if you've never prayed that prayer to ask Jesus to come into your life, to be a part of your life, I want to give you the chance to do that today. So everybody get nice and quiet and repeat after me if you want to accept Jesus into your life. God, I know that I'm a sinner. I know I do things wrong. I know I make mistakes. But I believe, Jesus, that you came. And that's what we're celebrating at Christmas, that you came to earth for us, that you came and died on the cross and you rose again and you're alive in heaven and you're inviting us to be a part, to walk through our lives with you, Jesus. Jesus, I ask you to come into my life. Be with me. Be with me when it's hard. Be with me when it's good. Be a part of my life. Be my very best friend and my Lord and Savior, Jesus. I thank you for everything that you did for me. And I ask that you walk with me, Jesus, and help me. And in your name, we pray all these things. Amen. All right, boys and girls, if you prayed that prayer today for the very first time, we are so excited. We actually have something to send you. So text in your name and I chose Jesus to the number on the screen and we'll send you something. And boys and girls, if you're here in person with us today, tell one of us, tell your leaders, because we are so excited. We want to celebrate and give you something as well. Well, that's all the time we have for today, but let's say our big idea together one more time on the count of three. One, two, three. Everyone is invited to be a part of God's story. Awesome job, boys and girls. And we want you to remember, no matter what, that Jesus loves you and we do too. Bye-bye.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday.